Hello and welcome to this webinar about import and analyzing of public data from SRA, GEO and TCGA in Qlucore Omics Explorer. You will be muted during the webinar, but you can post your questions using the chat in WebEx. So I hope you can see the screen and everything is working properly on your side. First, some short background. Qlucore was started about 10 years ago in Lund in Sweden. We got customers in around 35 countries. We sell mostly in Western Europe and in North America, but we also have distribution in large parts of the world. So you can see overview there. If you would like to read a bit more, you can go to our webpage where there are references, there are a lot of case studies and other information that could be useful. The tool itself, fast and easy to use tool to analyze and explore data. You don't have to be a statistical expert to do so. And we can work with a number of different data types. And today I will focus on data that we get from public sources, mainly from SRA today. But as you can see, there are many different sources that you can work with when it comes to data. The objectives of the webinar today is to have a look at the following. We will try to identify an experiment and associated files, download FASTQ files using the SRA toolkit, align FASTQ files to get BAM files, load BAM files into Qlucore Omics Explorer, and we'll also have a look at gene expression omnibus and TCGA download and how to use the 10x genomics cell ranger data import. But this is a bit special webinar today. We will normally focus on how to use Omics Explorer in different situations, but today we'll have a look at public data from the SRA public repository. And as you understand, much of the data that you'll find there is quite huge. The files are in many cases many gigabytes. And therefore, I will not demonstrate very much today. Instead, I will use screenshots to guide you through the different parts here. We have also prepared a document that I hope we'll be able to send out tomorrow, and that will also get more into detail how to run different scripts and so on in order to work with this kind of data. But first, I would just like to remind you that you can actually download data from Gene Expression Omnibus directly if they are in the format of soft files. So you go under File, Download, GeoDataset, just specify the name there and press OK, and then that type of data can be imported. However, in many cases today, people are working with RNA sequence data and store them instead in the sequence read archive, SRA, and in those cases you mostly work with raw data and it needs to be pre-processed in order to be imported into Omics Explorer. And that is what we will focus on today. So a lot of the things in this webinar covers other things than Omics Explorer itself, but rather how to work with the data in order to prepare it. If we're looking at what is required to work with this type of data, you normally need a fast computer, a fast hard disk, and a fast internet connection. So let's assume, for instance, that you have an Apple iMac with an Intel i7 processor with 4 cores, something like that. And let's assume that you have around 200 files on a sequence files. Well, first you need to download the files, and that will take several minutes to do so, and there are support for that, and I will go through the tools that you can use for that type of download. And sometimes you need also to retry a number of times. There could be some hiccups when you do download, and therefore it's also important to really go through the files and see that you have collected everything that's needed from the project. If we look at disk space, well, if we have this many files and we have them at the size of perhaps 10 gigabytes per file, then you will need probably in the range of 2 to 4 terabytes of space for FASTQ files, spam files and log files in total. So it requires that you have quite a lot of disk space too. Not all projects, of course, have 200 files, but just to remind you that it could require something like that. Processing may also take time. The files that we can download from the SRA archive is files that are mostly in FASTQ file formats, and we need then to align them with an aligner. And that may take between 5 and 10 minutes, up to perhaps 30 minutes, depending on how the FASTQ file is organized. So it may take some time also just to do the alignment. And then, of course, you need to load and normalize the BAM file in Omics Explorer. It may take several minutes per file the first time, but then you save the G data file that you have gotten, and the next time when you open it, you will open it in just a few seconds. So that's the whole trick here, to go something from something that's very large and very complex into something that's easy to use within Qlucore Omics Explorer. And I hope I can guide you through the different steps here that are needed. If we look first at the sequence read archive, it's organized in a way where you have a number of specified names for different things in the hierarchy of files. All data is organized into studies. You have something called a bioproject name that encapsulates the entire study. And there may be a similar entity also in GEO. So we can look both in the gene expression omnibus and in the SRA when we're looking at the same study. Studies contain samples, often starting with SRS. And samples have experiments, SRX, performed on them. And then you have a number of results recorded from different runs. And those runs, they have IDs beginning with the SRR prefix. So we will probably work with a lot of SRR files that we would like to download. And together, this forms a hierarchy, and it's well described in the README in the SRA archive. So it's possible to go through the different components there and see how things are related. Let's take an example here, the GEC 147507 that I've taken here that I played a bit with this summer. It's an example here. It's rather complex. It contains samples from two species. We both have human samples, and we have also samples from ferret. It's actually a COVID-19 data set that we have here. So we have, for the first, two platforms, one which is Illumina NextSeq 500 for human, and then we have the same for ferret. We have our samples. There is a total of around 110 samples, but since we have several runs per sample, we have a total of around 230 different runs here, or FASTQ files that we can download. The bioproject name we have here, and also a study identifier. And we can, of course, click on some of those and have a look at it. I will do that directly here. And we'll see if we can get here so we can get some more information. So now I'm at the gene expression omnibus that I hope you can see on the screen here. And we can see when this was published in March 2020, so a bit a year ago. And here we have some more information about it. We can see the two platforms, information about the samples. You can also see the bioproject identifier here, and you can click on that. SRA identifier for the project here, SRP, and the number that we have down there. In this case, we also have two supplementary files that you can download. That's read counts, raw read counts that you can download also. We won't use that in this webinar, but in some cases you have this type of raw read counts, and in some other cases you do not. Some other cases you may have 10x files here as well, and there could be other supplementary files that you have. But in this case, we'll focus on the raw files that we have as FASTQ files in the SRA today. I will go back to the presentation again. So this was just one slide here about this. I will go to the next here. And if we go directly to the SRA, we can get some more information also about the individual samples that we have here. And here you can find more information about the whole project that we are going to have a look at. And this is then the link for that. I won't go there just now, but you can do that also and have a look at the project. At the SRA, there is also something called a run selector, where you can have a look at the individual runs. In this case, as I said, we have quite a lot of them for this project here. And then you can have a more detailed look at the runs that are available here. Here you can see, for instance, that we have 231 runs for the human part of this project, and we have 98 of from the ferret part that we have here. So in total, we have over 300 different runs, and that will of course take some time to download as well. But here you can read more about it, and you can for each of the runs, you can see then how things are then related to the biosamples and so on. So you can see how that also are related within the run selector here. So this is the online version that you have here. I will also go into the one where you can do this from the command line and then use a tool that's downloadable from the SRA that we'll have a further look into. And as you can see here, you have in many cases several runs for each of the samples. And if you would like to download all that information, the list and so on, you can do that in different formats. One format here is the so-called accession list, and it's a text file that you can download in download it either with the humans only, or you can select to do that for the ferrets or a combination in this case. You can also download the run info and then got much more detailed information. This file, the SRA ACC list.txt, is a file that you can use as input when you download individual files using the SRA toolkit software. So we'll have a look at that. And what's the SRA toolkit then? Well, that's a piece of software that you can download both as source files and as a pre-compiled version from GitHub. And that allows you to access data from the SRA and convert it into a number of different formats, like FASTA files, FASTQ files, and also SAMP files that you can download. And this toolkit is available on a number of different platforms, on macOS, MS Windows, and also in different Linux distributions. And here is the link to it. And as I said before, there is a document about this also, so you don't need to take notes here. We will send out information about this. When you have downloaded the tool, you can see that there are several parts. One part here is the VDB config part, which you can use to configure the SRA toolkit, mainly to decide where you would like to have your user folders, where you would like to have your log and processing files, etc. So that's something that you need to set up, otherwise it will all go into some default folders, which is perhaps not very handy. Then you can write a command called prefetch, and the prefetch command is one of those that you get with the SRA toolkit, that part of the program will collect data from the SRA and download it to your own local computer. And this is how it may look like. You have the command prefetch, then you have an option file where you can specify the SRA ACC list.txt, and also the type of download that you would like to do, in this case, FASTQ files. And this is how the log may look like below here. You can see that we have started the prefetch command, and you can see that it starts to download the different FASTQ files here. And this may take some time also, as you can see here. It may take several minutes depending on the size and, of course, on the speed of the internet connection that you have. And you can select different parts of the world where you can download the data also. So it's possible to do that from different repositories with the same information. When you have downloaded the files, and as I said before, you have to be a bit careful. There may be some hiccups, and then you need to run the command again. It will only then pick the things that have not been completely downloaded, and after a while you will get all of the data downloaded to your computer. And it's large files, the FASTQ files, so you need to have a lot of disk space there. Now the next step here is to use an aligner to convert your FASTQ files into BAM files. BAM files can be imported into Qlucore Omics Explorer, but first we need them to be aligned. And the reason that we do not provide an aligner is that there are so many aligners on the market, and people have different pipelines to align their data, their FASTQ data, which means that they have their own favorites. Many of those aligners are open source software, and we have to look at the respective software for the licensing term, etc. And here are some examples: Star, HiSET2, Bowtie2, BVA, etc. And they are normally available as source code. Some have pre-compiled libraries, normally Linux, but in some cases also Mac OS. Microsoft Windows support is quite rare on the native basis, but there may be support for building the liner on Windows. And in some other cases, if you would like to run on Windows, then you can have a Linux installation on top and then run the aligner in that environment. But in this webinar here, we will have a look at it on Mac OS. And since Mac OS is not that far from Unix, it's in most cases like that. But if there is support for Linux, they may have also, within the group that have created the aligner, also made a Mac OS version, and in some cases also pre-compiled it. You also need to have a GTF file, a gene transfer file, that's needed in the process, and also needed when you import the BAM file into Qlucore Omics Explorer. And you can get your BAM, your GTF files from many different sources. Here is an example here that you can use to find GTF files. And in some cases, you can also read in the documentation for the experiment that you would like to work with, the public data that you have just downloaded, which version of the GTF file that was used by those that published the data. And then, of course, you should try to use that GTF file too. Otherwise, the best guess is perhaps to go to one of the public sources that we have here on this page and see if you can download a GTF file for the species that you're working with. Next step here is to run an aligner, and here is how it could look like. You have to go through all the FASTQ files that you have in a library somewhere. And in this case, this is an example with a star aligner, and it takes a number of options. In this case, I've put a number of options there in order to have it working on the Mac OS machine that I tested it out on with this aligner. And here you can see that you also have specified a certain folder where we have created an indexed information about the genome that we are currently working with for the aligner. We can also see that the output here is BAM sorted by coordinate, meaning that we will have a BAM file and it will be sorted by coordinate, which is the one that we can easily read. And this is how the log output from such a script could look like. And as I said before, there will be documentation sent out regarding this webinar, so you don't have to take notes of everything here, since there are quite a lot of different things to take into account when you run scripts. Here we can see that here we started, in this case the star aligner, and it started star here for one file, and then it takes some time here, finish mapping, start sorted, finish successfully, and here at about 10 minutes later it is ready with that file, and so on. So it could take 5-10 minutes, but also for some complex files that I've seen in some rare cases, it has taken quite a lot more time, probably because the FASTQ files have been organized in a more complex way. So it will depend on how the FASTQ files are organized, the time it takes to align the data. But the result that you will get here are sorted BAM files, and they may look something like this. This was, as I said, a COVID data set here that I had a look into. And we can see that the different files here that end with BAM, and it says also that it's sorted by coordinate. And this is the output that we get here from each of the files that we have been working with. So now we have the BAM files, and now we can actually go to the next step, and that is to import the BAM files into Omics Explorer. So there are a number of different steps here that you need to take. First, to download the data, you need to download also the different software that you would like to use, for instance, the SRA toolkit, and you need to have also an aligner available that you can use. You also need to have the correct GTF files and so on. So it takes some time to prepare a project like this, but it's not something that's very difficult. It just takes some preparation and also some time to process the data. But after this, we have our BAM files. So it's now time to look at how we can go to the next step. And here I have started Qlucore Explorer. And then you can go to the program to file open BAM files, and then you will get this dialogue started. Here you specify the GTF file that you would like to use here, and then you specify also the normalization method that you would like to use. You can also, if you would like to do some filtering of your data, perhaps not needed the first time here. And you can also tell if you got stranded or non-stranded data. And below here, you can see the individual BAM files, and those are the files from this experiment that I talked to about before. You can either select the whole folder with the information, or you can select individual files here. And in this case, it would have been, if we were only looking at humans, around 230 files. If we had a ferrets too, around 100 extras that could be needed also to be imported. But nose, that's another GTF file for ferret, so we can then do that in a separate go. So this was just for the humans here. Then you press OK, and this may also take some time to complete when you have many files. So it could take several minutes for each of the files to be loaded and then to be normalized. So this is something just like alignment and so on. You probably start it, go home for the day, and then you come back in the morning and the things have been imported. So after this, you have completed open BAM files. All files have been read in, and you can see the first PCA plot. And the next thing here is to save the data set with Save As in Qlucore Omics Explorer. So you go to File, and then you go down to Save As. And now we have taken all the data we have from the SRA. We have then piped it through the aligner. We have imported it into Qlucore Omics Explorer. And we have saved it as a GE data set. And now we can next time open the whole data set here in just a few seconds. So from having something that takes hours and so on to compile from the SRA, we have now something that we can open in just a few seconds. And that's very handy, of course. Now we can do the real work with our data, and that's what we would like to do, of course. Sometimes you also, in this process, change the sample identifier, because when you have imported your BAM files, you probably get the whole path name as the identifier for each of the samples here, often called full path. And here you can see that it's a quite long name, and in many cases, that's something that you don't want to work with within the data set. If you go to the data tab within Omics Explorer, you can then change here your identifier for the samples from a full path to file name. So just select file name there, and then it will no longer be full path. That's the unique identifier. Instead, it will be file name. And then you can save the data set again using file export data. And then for the future work, you will have a file name or whatever you select to have there as the identifier for the data set. Makes it a bit easier than having all those characters within the full path name as the identifiers. So that's good advice. In many cases, you also have additional information on your samples. Now, this information may or may not be available for the data set that you have downloaded from SRA. They may have provided it in some other format. It could be a text file or something like that, because that file information or sample information is not available within the FASTQ files. It's available outside. So when we work with the data set and would like to do exploration or statistical analysis, it is probably something that we would like to add to our data set. And then we should have something like a text file or CSV file or something like that, where we, for each of the rows that we have there, have the unique identifier that we have in our data set, like the one that we selected before as the unique identifier in the previous step as the identifier. And then you can add columns here with those annotations that you have for your different samples here or runs, so like age, gender, treatment, etc., etc., that you would like to add to your data set. And how do you import this when you have a file like this? Well, you go to File, Import Sample Annotations, and then this information will be imported into your data set. It will add for each of the identifiers this information here for, in this case, file one, which was then the first sample, and then file two, the second, etc. So then we have a annotations that could be useful also. It mustn't look exactly like this, of course, but that's something that you can decide yourself if you have additional information for the data set or not. And then you can save that information as well. So this was a walkthrough of the different steps here that is needed to be taken when you import data from SRA through an aligner, and then finally as BAM file import. There was a question here, how do I find RNA sequence data sets online? Well, my advice there would be to go to the SRA itself and do a search. And you can also, if you would like to, start within Gene Expression Omnibus, if you would like to. There you can search for things like RNA sequence data. So you can search which type of file or input you are looking for. And then you can search for instance, like you have here, leukemia. You can search for diabetes or whatever. And then you will get a short list of data sets that are available. And in some cases, then they are not available in Gene Expression Omnibus. They are available in the SRA. And then you can go from GEO to SRA. Or you can do your search directly in the SRA as well. But I will send out more information on that topic as well as a part of the documentation here for this webinar. There's a few other things that I would like to mention at the very end. One is import of 10x genomic cell ranger data, because it's not uncommon that people have been using 10x cell ranger, and in those cases, in some cases also supplied the files from cell ranger as supplementary files in the gene expression omnibus part where we have this. Then it's possible for you to download them directly and use our 10x genomic cell ranger input template. You need to have three files: barcodes, features, and matrix, and those should be produced by the cell ranger pipeline directly, and then you can import them using our 10x genomics import. I will show you how that looks like also, so you can get a feeling for that. So that's under templates here. Here there is a 10x genomics assistant here, and here you can just put a path here to the folder where you got those three files. Then you can press execute and it will start to import the data. Takes just a few minutes to do so, but I won't show it to you now because we can spend the time looking at some of the other things here. But it's very straightforward, and in those cases when you have that information available, then it's a good idea that you go there directly and do the import there. One thing more perhaps about this also, cell ranger can produce both normalized and unnormalized data, so good to know if it's normalized or unnormalized data that you have there in those files. They have to read documentation there. Some of our customers also are working with TCGA data that's also publicly available, of course, and then you can download that information as well. You just have to comply to the terms that are you need to do for downloading them. We have a template for this as well, and then data will be downloaded directly into the tool. I will show you also this part so you can see where you can find it. So I will leave this template here. We will go to the TCGA part here, which is another template here. And here we have a number of different cohorts that you can download from. So you can just select one. They have different names here, and you can select if you want to have normalized or non-normalized data, and then just press execute, and it's executing a template, and then it starts to download the data and so on. So if you know that you would like to use this type of cancer data sets and so on, there is a template that you can directly use for this download within the tool also. So that's also possible to use here. And let's see. Zoom get ready probably here. So here it is, data set here with 196 samples and around 20,000 variables that has been downloaded. So if you're working with TCGA, then you can directly download that. In some cases, you can also find at Gene Expression Omnibus that you have row count data. And that could also be saved there as supplementary files. Then you can use our wizard to import that data. It's available under file, open with wizard, and then you have to select, there is within the different steps for the wizard that you have raw count data. There is a ready button at the very beginning of the sequence that you go through in the wizard. If you select that, then you can select also the normalization method, and you can then import your data. Note the normalizations here, they work best, of course, if you have information about the feature length, the length of each of the genes, then you can use that information to take into account when the normalization is done. So that's something that is of importance too. And in some cases, people have not saved that information together with the raw count information there. So you have to see if the data that you have there is normalized or not. If it's not normalized, you can import it, but it's better than to have the feature length information. If it's already normalized, you can use the wizard too. Then you don't have to go through the step with the raw count data. You can directly import it with a wizard. That's all that I'm going to cover today in this webinar. As I said before, there is a document that we'll send out probably tomorrow or the day thereafter, but in this week, regarding the different steps here. And it's a quite long document about how to work with this. So take your time to read through and so on. And there are also some things that you need to take into account, of course. The type of aligner that you would like to use. We have just given one example here. And there are, of course, many different aligners and other types of free software that could be useful. If you have any questions now, you can just post them in the chat. No questions. Then I would like to thank you very much.